Hello friends, this is Vasant Nayak from Vastech channel. Please subscribe to our channel. We will update latest information for you. Thank you.
Hello student, this is Vasant Nayak from Vastech channel. Welcome back. Today I will explain one more program, that is 6th program of 18 CSL 48 syllabus, that is to find out the largest or smallest number. Okay. So this is the algorithm to find out the largest or smallest number. So this is the program. As usual, every program, the program starts with the TTL title. Title indicates the title of the program, followed by the area name. So here area is name given to area is program 6, and it is meant for code and it is mapped to read only memory. So before explaining this program, let me take you to the data area. Here you can see two areas by name SRC and destination of type data only. So in the first area, I have stored a set of numbers, that is an array, and the name given to the first location of this array is array itself. And I am going to store the result in one location, and the name given for that location is LS. Both are DCD. DCD means a defined constant data. It is an assembler directive. It will tell the assembler to reserve the memory in terms of 4 bytes of memory and align the memory with the 32 bits boundaries. So next, move to the program. What I am doing is I am loading the address of the array in register R0. I am loading the address of the result, that is largest number I am going to store here, that is in R2. And I am loading number 9 in R1, because I have 9 numbers stored in array. For that I am taking one iterator here, and I will store that number in R1. Now load the first number from this location to R3, LDR R3 comma R0 in bracket comma #04. This is something called as a forced index method. What do you mean by forced index method? Here, the first, the number will be loaded from this location to R3, and the address will be incremented by 4. That means, suppose in this example, I will take some number something like this. The first number is, I will take the first number is 3. First number is 3. Second number is 4. And third number is I will take 2, fourth number I will take 5, something like this. Now while executing first instruction, suppose this is the starting address of the number, and this number is loaded to register R3. After that, R0 is, that is address is incremented by 4. That means now address is pointing to second number. Please remember, address is pointing to second number. This is called as a forced index addressing mode. We have discussed forced index addressing mode in the theory session. Now similarly, here load the second number, because now already address is pointing to the second number, right? Load that into register R4 and increment the address. Now the address is pointing to third number. Now compare two numbers. Now what is there in R3? So let me write here, R3 is equal to 3 and R4 is equal to 4. What compare will do? Compare will subtract 3 minus 4. When it subtract 3 minus 4, there is a borrow. There is a borrow, right? There is a borrow. Borrow means you have to remember in ARM C is equal to 0. C is equal to 0. That indicates 3 is lesser than 4. So here move next statement is move LS, move ls means lower or same. Lower or same, that means it results in same means zero flag, or lower means borrow is there. Borrow is there means carry is equal to zero. Remember this point, carry is equal to zero, not one. Carry is equal to zero. Here you can see, here it is written carry, lowercase carry, that is zero. Either zero flag enabled or carry flag is zero. That means carry, borrow is there. Carry is equal to zero. Borrow is there. That indicates borrow is there. In that case, what you do? You have to move R4 to R3. That is, I am moving 4 to 3. I want to find out largest number. Right. I want to find out largest number. Move this into 3. So now R3 becomes 4. Okay. Now subtract R1 is equal to 1. So subtract 1 from R1. Earlier our case, just take 9. 9 minus 1, 8. Compare that with 0. Not equal, jump here. It will come here. If it is not 0, it will come here. Now it will load one more number. So now, as I said, it is pointing to third number, right? It will load that into register R4. So it will load this number. What is this number? Number, this is 2. This is loaded into register R4. Now what is there in R3? It is 4 is there, and R4 it is 2. Now it will compare 4 minus 2. This time there is no borrow. If there is a borrow, you move the number. Otherwise, don't move, because we want to find out largest number. Anyway, 4 is largest when you compare with the 2. So this case will repeat 9 times till it find out the largest number. So finally, the largest number is stored in register R3, and it is moved to this location. Please remember, this is the one case. Otherwise, if you want to find out smallest number, then that time, let me clear this one. That time you have to replace move ls by move hi. Move hi. What is this? Hi or hs? Highest or same? Move highest or same. That time there is no borrow. Highest or same. Suppose you take the first number 4, second number 3. Here, when it compare, it will subtract 4 minus 3. So 4 is higher than 3. So there is no borrow. Carry is equal to 1. It is opposite to our Intel processor. Please remember, carry is equal to 1. See here. Yes, I highlighted the carry flag here. Carry is equal to 1. That time, this is the highest number, this is the smallest number. We will exchange number here. We will move R4 to R3, because we want to find out the smallest number this time. So this technique we are using here. And with this technique, it works. It is possible to find out the largest or smallest number. Let us directly move to now our program. So, I'll open the program here. You can see the program already opened in Keel version 4. Let me write here first. I want to find out the largest number. So, I told for the largest number, you have to write ls means lower or same. Move lower or same. So let me save this one, and you can see here number here, all these are number, and we want to find out highest number. Which is highest number here? This is the highest number. Okay, let me find out. So execute this one, and we'll rebuild this one. Fine. Then debug. Where is our debug shortcut key? This is the debug shortcut key. Click evaluation mode. And when you go to debug, it will open three windows. We know as usual, that is the project window, disassembly window, and program window. Other than that, memory window and command window, right? Yes. So now you want to execute the program. You can execute the program either by step by step or at once. If you go for step by step, then you have to see first. This is the case where 10 iteration is there. Suppose you imagine you have 100 numbers and in that number you want to find out the largest number, then 100 iterations. So that time step by step will not work. So better what we can do, instead of going for step by step, we can directly go for a which one? Yeah, correct. Click on this one, execute once. So click here and click on this button and you can see now largest number is in register R3. Register R3. So I will take you to that this one. So here you can see our number is finally stored here, right? Register R3. R3 will contain the number and from R3 we will store the number to address location pointed by R0. What is address location pointed by R0? 400000, right? So let me go to memory now. I will open memory window. So memory window, this is memory window. Let me open once again memory window. Yeah, here I will type what I will type memory location. So 0x400000. How many zeros? So yeah, like 4 followed by 7 zeros. 1, 2, let me count 5, 6, 7, 8. Enter. And you can see here the largest number is here, right? So let us now modify the program to find out the smallest number. So I will stop the debug window. And what I will do, I will write here LS means move, LS means lowest or same, lower or same, then lower or same, HS instead of low, this one LS I will put HS, higher or same, I will put this one, higher or same, and I will save this program, I will rebuild it, then I will compile and rebuild. And I will execute debug mode. It will take me to debug mode. I will execute it. This one at once. And now you can see here the lowest number is there. Lowest number is there. Let me take you to the memory also once again. And in memory also it is visible. Lowest number 11111. In this way you can find out largest or lowest number. Only the logic you have to remember here is let me repeat once again, logic you have to remember here is LS, lower or lower or same. LS means lower or same. That means move LS, move what command we used here, move LS R3 and comma R4. Before that we have one statement, compare R3 and R4, you know. Before that, we have one statement used, that is compare R3 and R4. That means R3 and R4. Suppose you take R3 is equal to 3 and R4 is equal to 4. Now, this number is lesser than this number. That means it will, while subtracting, it will take borrow. If borrow is there, then carry is equal to 0. So if carry is 0, then on the next instruction, I will move 4 to this place so that I can find out largest. Similarly, if I use MOHI, higher or same, that time suppose the number is, I want to find out the smallest and number is something like this, first number is 4 and second number is 3, that time there is no borrow, that means carry is equal to 1, and if carry is equal to 1, then what it will do, it will move this to this place. In this way our program works. So if any feedback, please post in your comment section. Thank you. Bye-bye.